I'm just taking myself off drive and putting myself into a live on duty, live load on my records here. Okay, I'm gonna go check in. This seems a little... backwards. I don't know how else to say it. It looks backwards. You can already see the parking lots. It is muddy and has holes. I think there's one, two, well, that guy's a flatbed, and this guy is waiting. So.
Checks in today. We're all done.
You're done for
actually,
the day.
We're going on strike.
Wow.
I'm messing with you. Where are you going?
Monaca, Pennsylvania.
You got like an agency number?
Yeah. Creek, Ohio, and I kind of took a back way to get here because I was up in Sandusky, and we're in the middle of Amish country. Well, Amish is in mainly in Pennsylvania, but Amish also has spread out off. They're in Indiana, I've seen them, Kentucky, Michigan, Ohio, of course, and I think that's it. But they're mainly off of like 80 and 70. So the Amish are, if you don't know what Amish are, they're a group of, I think they're German. I think their background is German, but they're very strict with their beliefs and the Bible and church, and they don't really, there's Mennonites and then there's Amish. So Amish are really strict, and Mennonites are, Amish, I don't think they socialize at all with the English. They call us English, even though we're American. We're all American. You know, they call us English. But Mennonites do. Mennonites still have all, like, the beliefs and the church and the Bible and all that. But they are more open to what we're using today, like technology, phones, electricity, you know, stuff that we're using today. And Amish are really strict. They don't really want to associate themselves with people who aren't Amish. And sometimes there's their children, like they'll have easily like 8-10 children in a family, easy. But they're about the Bible and family and spending time together and working on the farm and cooking and baking and sewing. So I think they make their own dresses and clothes. But they're really, really reserved, and they're very strict, the Amish. Very strict. But yeah, it's pretty cool. Pretty cool. Okay, well, we're just waiting, standing by. So I'm here, and then it's really cool because there's a farm right next to me. A bunch of cows. Cool. I have to be discreet because it's rude to take people's pictures and everything and video and stuff without asking. And I know they're like anti pictures and stuff. Love them. Love them. Love the Amish and Mennonites. Clothes out to dry. online, which is cool. It just seems like they have such a simple life, you know what I mean? No distractions, and I wouldn't mind living on an Amish farm. You know? I wouldn't mind to get away from it all. Get away from the city life and the hustle and bustle. It just seems so peaceful, you know? I admire it. Dropping this off. I'm headed to Monaca, Pennsylvania, and it's due by 8. It's now 4:00.
In 3/4 of a mile, turn right on Dover Road.
So, we'll see you there. Look at this. Visitors must check in with the security office prior to entering and exiting the facility. Okay, well, let's just get in. Check in here. Hi, so we made it. I'm gonna check in, see what they want, where they want me to go. This looks awkward in here. They're all awkward. They're all tough. Okay, I'll be right back.
There's not much on there, just wooden pallets. Like a half a trailer. Okay. So this was kind of a weird day. I dropped off a load this morning about 7:30, and then they didn't have anything on my dispatch. I waited probably about 3 hours. But that's the longest I've ever had to wait. Because they're trying to get me home tonight. So they probably were trying to find something to get me home. So I don't care. It gave me time to clean the truck, you know, walk. That's what I do, is when I have any downtime at all, I take advantage of it. Work out, you know, anything that you can do with your time, because sometimes it's just wears you out here, you know. It just really kind of, it wears you out, because I'm not really working an 8-hour day. I have 11 hours of drive time and a 14-hour clock, and the 14-hour clock starts ticking as soon as you start your clock. And then I have a 10-hour break. So it just gets kind of, it can get tiring out here, especially when you don't really have anybody else in here to talk to, or, you know, it's rough. It can be rough, but the driving's easy. The driving is so, like, I like driving. Anyway. Okay, so that's it. Oh, what was I going to say about the load? Oh, so I came here to Monaca, and it's like 7:30 at night. I've never been to this place. Stolzy or something like that. But this is a little small town in Pennsylvania, right near Pittsburgh. Not far from Pittsburgh. But this big business is right in the middle of these homes. And I guess that's how it used to be back in the day. But anyway. Okay, well, thanks for watching. So you got a little bit of a day trucking and evening trucking. Okay, I'll see you next time, okay? Bye. Mwah. Love you.